Hi friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Lori and thank you so much for clicking on this video. Love to have you, would love to keep having you, so please hit that bell button, subscribe, comment. And yeah guys, welcome to episode 11. I need to get better. I know, I need to get better with being more consistent with these vlogs and not making the gap in between videos too long. You know, I know last time it was because I was kind of in a down mood, and you know, I've been okay, so that's not the reason why. It's just, I guess, work, life, things have just been a little busy, and I kind of had this mindset to where I don't want to post a new vlog, of course, until I have enough footage, but until it reached a certain amount of views. But I think I need to totally get out of that mindset and just be like, look, whether it's like two people that watch it or two people or 2 million, just post it and be consistent. And I'm like giving advice to myself, but yeah, I'm just gonna try to post more. I just kind of want to make sure I have enough content for each video before I post it too. But I am going to San Diego this week, so that's pretty exciting. That'll be on episode 12. But yes, I'm gonna work on it, gonna be more consistent. And shorts, if you're using the YouTube app, please make sure to watch my shorts, because I actually do post shorts more than I post vlogs, but I'm gonna work on doing both. Okay, balance. But yes guys, again, thank you for watching and hope you enjoy the vlog. This is a little bit of things that have been going on through the month of August. Can't believe it's already August. Well, yeah, I can't believe that, but I'm also glad because I hate the summer. I hate the summer with my whole heart. I'm so sorry. Like, I know it's stupid because I was born and raised in Houston, so everybody's like, well, you should now. It's always hot there. It never gets cold. Yes, I know. But just because I live here doesn't mean I need to love the heat. You know, I hate it. I can't wait for the winter. And I know we don't even get like winter, but I can't wait until it at least gets cooler. Okay, just let me live. But yes, guys, thank you again for clicking on this vlog. Please comment, subscribe. Would love to have you come back for more. Go ahead and click that little bell button, comment. I would love to interact with you guys more. And yes, hope you enjoy the vlog and see ya. Hi friends, good morning. I just woke up from a nap. It is Sunday, July 14th. A few days post Hurricane Beryl that happened here in Houston. And a lot of people still don't have light. To this day, we lost light, but it was we got it back Tuesday evening. It was not that long, but it was still rough. It was hot. But now we're down here about to go to, I'm kind of like down in my step because I just woke up from a nap. I was tired. We're here at pitch 25.
We're not there yet.
Is it pitch 21, pitch 25? Pitch 25. And can you tell them what game this is, Chip?
This is Colombia versus Argentina in the Copa of the Americas, the final, the finale.
Yeah, and George is there, so we're about to go meet up with him. So, see y'all there. Bye.
Boo, 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 boo. Out of
everybody. It's loud. It is Friday, July 19th, and if y'all have seen the other vlog, we came to this location for a 90s art show, and now we're back again. Same location. I'll put it right here. Nansen Art Studios. I'm probably saying that wrong, but it's now, today, it's a horror-themed show, so I tried, y'all. My little Frankie, can't see it, and then his wife on the side. I tried, but yeah. All right, see you inside. Enjoy.
The whole point is that you're eating a spoon.
It was a spoon.
They were dirty. He was like, there's only spoons in there. I went right behind him.
Fork. I didn't see a fork.
When we came back, I was like, how the this eating noodles with a fork and with a spoon.
I didn't see a fork.
He doesn't.
I got the first clean utensil.
So
I'll say this.
Let
so
me know.
At work,
if you go eat with
I'm
people,
already expected to have my
and you get your food before then,
my days off,
regardless if it's a girl or a guy, do you wait until
but
they have their food to eat,
people,
or are you kind of like screw it? Like I got my
if
food,
I
I'm hungry.
Okay.
What do you do? What do y'all do? Put it in the comments below.
I'm not mad at like 15 minutes before us. We were waiting. No, you weren't.
He
you were trying to kill that.
Because he waited for me.
You're eating with a. I waited for Lori, like
yes.
A goddamn gentleman.
My man.
Oh, well, I told him from the jump, I'm going to get a table. And I went over to the table.
He didn't get the table.
But you still wait.
Oh, I'm just saying.
No, there was no tables available. There was so many people.
No, you can get a table, but you still wait, though.
100%.
That's etiquette.
My food is not going to get cold. Wait for your piece.
Etiquette.
Your food got cold because of the
so
spoon.
This is going to go toward, this is not any disrespect or anything like that, but when Lori and I first started dating, So we would go out to eat and we would get our plates first and Lori's like, oh, I'm going to eat. I'm like, whoa, pump the brakes. No one else has gotten their food yet. Let's wait for them to get the food.
What an inconsiderate woman.
What for? Like, well, let's wait for everyone to get their food and we can all eat together. No, I got my food. I'm eating now.
She ain't got no manners.
No, mind your matters.
You got a teacher.
Yeah.
Back of your hand.
If my food is getting cold because I'm waiting on you.
No, your food is getting cold because of the spoon.
Yeah.
That's why it got cold, because of the spoon. You couldn't pick anything up.
I don't even know what to say. They're having a good time. It's always, check this out. That's what I was sitting in the back seat of. So if y'all remember that last vlog, we went to the art show, the 90s art show. We came to Guillermo's restaurant, which is exactly where we're at again here. So that's where we're at. That's what's going on. They're still back there. Ah, let's stick my teeth.
Oh, fuck.
Good guys, it was great.
That was gnarly.
Beautiful.
I'm not gonna lie, that was a blast. We should do obviously that next one, but then also it's dangerous business. That way you mean.
Guillermo, you weren't here. We love the food, but we left because we kind of came for you. So, next stop. Tell Guillermo you miss
him. Next stop.
We miss you, Guillermo. We came for you, bud.
It's cool, Gmo. Came for you, but no big deal.
Hey, carpool karaoke, let's go.
They're not.
Midnight, dude.
Oh, they are. Have any of y'all tried the new iced coffee from Whataburger yet? Like, would iced coffee from Whataburger be good? I don't even know. So there was like vanilla, caramel. There was another sign up there. Oh, that's cute. But yeah. Let me know if y'all tried this in the comments below. Let me know if it's good. Looks good. In the picture. Hi friends, hope you're doing well. Today is Saturday the 3rd, I believe. Saturday the 3rd. And I am about to head to my local Ross to see what they have. I haven't been there in like, I don't know, over a month. So usually when I don't go for that long, whenever I do go, it's like a surprise to see like what goodies they may have. And I know some stores are putting out Halloween decor or Halloween items out. So we love that. I guess I can't completely explain it yet because, so, you know, I got some, I know y'all know I'm done with school. I graduated college 3 times. So I'm basically gonna go on another journey with school. I will disclose that maybe in a later episode. But right now I just kind of want to keep it like just for me at the moment, because to be honest, I didn't even tell my husband about this. I didn't tell my mom. I didn't tell for those of you that went to my wedding, my father's surgeon, who is a really big figure in my life now along with my family. I didn't even tell him. He's a huge like mentor of mine in this medicine journey, and I didn't even tell him. Like, I didn't even tell Cynthia or George or anybody, probably not, and I didn't tell like all of them until, I don't know, like late or mid last month. And so I'll explain all of that in another vlog and down the line. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be vlogging because there's some cool things that are gonna come with that as well. But anyway, so I told, call him Dr. A. I told Dr. A, which is my mentor and my dad's surgeon. I told him the news, I think it was last week, and he was super surprised, very happy about it. And I had gotten something in the mail in relation to that yesterday, Friday, and I showed him a picture of it, and was like, look what arrived in the mail. And you know, he was like, I'm so proud of you, this and that, and saying that he's sure that I'm gonna do great, and like, you know, like without a doubt that I'm gonna do awesome. And like, I was so happy. Sorry, I don't know if y'all could hear me through the AC, but I, of course, like, that meant the world to me to hear him say that. Like, I was so happy. But at the same time, it immediately made me sad because I was like, wow, my dad can't tell me that. And I just, and like ever since yesterday, it immediately just like brought my mood like down. You see stuff like this is a perfect example of how grief works. I was absolutely fine. I mean, of course, not perfectly fine, but like I was fine. Like, I wasn't down in the dumps. I wasn't nothing. And, you know, and it wasn't even a sad situation that happened. It was him telling me, like, positive things. And then all of a sudden, it made me sad because it reminded me that I will not get to hear those words directly from my dad. And you see stuff like that, and then it just like, see, like I'm ugh, like it even makes me like kind of emotional now, because like for a second whenever he told me that, I kind of felt like it was my dad. And it's funny because I always tell Dr. A, and he actually did the father-daughter dance with me at the wedding. And you know, I always say, like, you know, nobody's gonna ever replace my dad, but I do see Dr. A, like, I see my dad so much in him because of all that we went through with him for my dad. And you know, so he reminds me a lot of my dad. He reminds me a lot of, like, a father figure. So for a second, like, although I knew it wasn't my dad, and although I was wishing it was my dad, I felt like it was my dad for that brief second. And then all of a sudden, like, boom, it just hit me that, like, yeah, you know, you can't hear those words from dad, like, dad, you know? Ugh, and then it just broke my heart, and I don't know, ever since yesterday, it kind of just, like, I don't know, put me down a little. And I didn't tell nobody, like, I didn't vlog it yesterday, because I try not to vlog, like, one-on-one dinners or moments, like, with my friends at times, you know, if I can avoid it, you know. And I hung out with George and Panda, who y'all know and have seen in other vlogs, and I didn't tell them about that, you know, because just sometimes you don't want to talk about it, because if you talk about it, it'll make you sad. See, I have problems. It's like, I know I should talk about it, I know I should fix it, but I don't. But I'm telling y'all, and I'll probably tell them now that I told you. But yeah, so see, I guess that's a perfect and transparent story and situation of ups and downs of grief, and kind of how you're fine one moment, and then the next minute, or next few days, next week, you come across a situation, you think of something, someone says something, and boom, you're back to just feeling sad. So yeah, that's kind of what happened. But at the same time, it's a very good thing that I'm, like, the situation that I'm referring to is a very good thing. It's super awesome. I it still hasn't hit me, and I know it probably won't hit me until I start doing whatever I need to do for it. Probably won't hit me until I go to the place and see everything for myself. Yeah, it's good stuff. Like, it's nothing negative, it's good things, but you know, it's just big milestones like that. You really wish that whenever you do have a loved one that has passed, you do wish that they could be there to see these things, to see them and just kind of enjoy them with you. And you know, oh, sorry y'all, I gotta cut the AC. Houston heat. Okay, sorry. I'll try to talk louder. But yeah, it's just, you know, and everybody's gonna tell you, oh, you know, don't worry, they'll be there in spirit, or you know, they're watching you, and his spirit's always watching you, blah blah blah, this and that. And like, yes, like, that's true. Like, I know, I get it, and I'm pretty sure anybody who has lost a loved one themselves can probably tell you, maybe they agree, maybe they don't, that yes, that is true, but it's not the same as if they were really there. Like, you could physically see them happy, you can audibly hear them tell you, like, I'm proud of you, or like, this is awesome, and stuff like that, you know. But yeah, so that was rambling, but y'all, thanks for the free therapy release. future Lori here. I just wanted to add in this little silly clip of my husband and my best friend at a good friend Jenny's daughter's birthday party, just so this won't end on a bad note. Enjoy. They were trying to hang up a pinata, by the way.
He has a ladder! I'm afraid of heights.
And that was the end of episode 11. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I'm in the car again. I've been in the car for a lot of this video. But I hope you guys enjoyed, as always. Please comment. Would love the interaction with you guys. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope you, and I had to put in that little clip at the end, that little, you know, Jeffrey and George being silly, because I didn't want it to end on a sad note. I wasn't trying to make the vlog said. I just wanted to put that in there because it was what I was feeling in the moment. It was real, so I just wanted to share that. And I hope you guys are okay with that. I'm pretty sure some of y'all fast-forwarded through that, but I apologize if it was too much. But like I said, I do want to... It's... I don't know. I guess it's still hard for me, too, to kind of put in personal, like, moments like that, because I'm very vulnerable when I talk about how I feel, and especially in regards to that. So just bear with me. If it's weird, I'll stop doing it. But I mean, and you can just always fast forward it too, but just wanted to be honest with how I'm feeling too, and not, like I said, not always rainbows and butterflies going on. So that's that. And the angle is really weird, but I'm trying to not show my scrub top because it has the name of my job on here, and I don't want to put that out here. But yeah, guys, again, thank you so much for watching. Happy to have new subscribers, and hope you guys come back for more. And episode 12 is going to be clips of the trip that I took this past weekend for work to San Diego. It was so beautiful, and I can't wait to share that with you guys. And I hope you guys have a good week as well. Take care. Bye.